La interpretación integrada en Zoom. Una vez que yo active la interpretación en la parte inferior de la pantalla, van a ver un globo y en ese globo van a poder seleccionar el idioma que quieren escuchar. Entonces, para este caso vamos a tener español e inglés, entonces solo tienen que seleccionar el idioma de su preferencia. Es opcional también si quieren silenciar el audio original porque se va a escuchar como de fondo, pero es algo que pueden hacer opcional. Y para todos los expositores, en este caso para Nadia, es muy importante que siempre seleccione el idioma. Entonces, Nadia, yo te pido el favor de que selecciones español. Igual para Irán cuando ingrese, hay que decirle que él selecciona el acento español para que no hayan conflictos de interpretación. Y listo. Entonces, siente si quieres me ayudas.
Hello, this is Cynthia. I will be your interpreter for the day. We would like to explain very quickly how the integrated interpretation function works. So first of all, please go to the main menu at the bottom of your screen. You will see this globe with the interpretation icon. So you click on that and the two options, Spanish and English, will appear. So select English in this case. And you will listen to me at all times. You will be able to speak through that same channel in English. And we suggest that if you mute your original audio.
Perfecto.
Thank
you. Muchas gracias. Gracias, Cinti. Entonces, en este momento voy a iniciar la interpretación. Y ahí estamos listos. Entonces, le pediría a Hugo Guerrero que haga la grabación en un idioma y a Norvin en otro idioma. Y Nadia, por favor, seleccionar la opción de español. Y ya
so
puedes.
Now you must be able to hear me on the English channel. Hello, good morning. My name is Nadia Monge. I am a specialist at IECA. I work in the Technical Cooperation Unit for some 8 years now. I am originally a specialist in international trade and international integration, but for many years I have worked with youth. I have been a cultural agent too, so I am very glad to be able to join you today to give the first presentation of this challenge. Welcome all. Thank you for the effort and for your participation, for checking the materials. Yesterday, we had a series of mentoring sessions. There were very good questions. And I see you, we have the results of part of the work yesterday. We will share that today. Today, we will also be talking about the results at IECA. We have consulted with several young people from the hemisphere from throughout the Americas. And they said how they were feeling now on occasion of the COVID, their concerns, the opportunities they have found. And we asked them if they wanted to be part of a community, a youth community. Why? Well, these are very diverse people from Canada down to Costa Rica, to Guatemala, St. Lucia, the Caribbean Islands, Colombia, Guatemala, Argentina. There are so many different realities for youth, particularly in the rural areas. So, yes, there are characteristics, challenges, and opportunities that we do have in common at the same time. Here at IECA, for Priscilla, Liana, Norbin, Marco, Manuel, Hugo, it would be very easy to organize a community of rural youth and start working. So yesterday, We were talking about a community. What is a community? Is much more than just a network. It is much more than a web platform, web-based platform, or a whole network. In the Caribbean, we have a platform, an incubator, a think tank, an agribusiness a think tank of youth. We have supporting staff, and we have something similar in the South. We have a network of family agriculture group of people, youth basically. So rural youth needs to be connected in all from all different angles with people that have other experiences, other knowledge, all those similar realities at the same time. So I will show you some infographics. This is a group of professional interns at ICA, very young people, just like all of you. And they are working for us now on an internship. And at 11 o'clock, as you see on the program, Costa Rica time, a person called Irán Ibarra, a Mexican, who is founder of the Young Entrepreneur of the Latin American Young Entrepreneur Association, will be joining us. When he connects, he will talk a bit about his experience and how that may be useful to you. Why? Because, I mean, connections are made up by people. So without further ado, let me talk to you about the results of what you mentioned in response to the different questions we posed yesterday. So when we asked, what are you experiencing as rural youth as to difficulties or challenges? The main answer was training, particularly support from public institutions, lack of technical assistance to carry out projects, basically a lack of opportunities. So why are we telling you all of this? Well, because the community that you are designing must respond one way or another to these issues or needs. So here we have access to funding. That is another major problem that was mentioned and that has worsened due to COVID. Access to technology, another bigger hurdle. And this is related, obviously, to access to funding, obviously. Well, why? In many rural areas, there's no internet, no connectivity, and very limited training to use these tools. That is very difficult to get. So it is a concern. Those problems existed before COVID. We know that. Ileana told you yesterday about all the problems and difficulties that rural youth is facing in different parts of the America, of the Americas. And all of this has worsened with COVID. So people say they continue to face those problems, but even stronger due to the pandemic. Also, another hurdle or difficulty mentioned was training and education, access to formal education. Since during a pandemic, there are many limitations. We are confined. We cannot go to schools. It is very difficult to finish the formal education and get a degree. And that limits access to a job, which is already in itself very limited. Jobs are a very important element for these communities.
Yo voy a proceder. Esta es una cuestión muy general.
This is a very general view of results we consulted. Let's see, here I am. I will show you a presentation that is in the kit that we forwarded to you, where we talk about this issue a bit more. Here we would like to tell you that we consulted people aged between the ages of 18 and 35. We had received responses in English and Spanish and Portuguese from the different parts of the Americas, and most of them are rural youth. So what I will do right now is explain a bit better this presentation. That we have prepared, including these issues and several others. I am being told that it's very difficult to see the screen, so let me see if I can work on this a minute so I can show this to you better. These are all elements or characteristics that you must take into account in your proposals. Whatever you propose will help us overcome these issues. So, let me share the screen again and see if it's better now. It is in English and in Spanish, so you can see it in both languages. Okay, there we go. So we asked you, how do you see yourselves? How do you describe yourselves? You have to consider this for whatever product you will develop. To be active participants in that community building the new projects. Young people are seen as helpers, are secondary actors, as the future, but the future is today, come on. So these characteristics are important. How do we see rural youth? So, in many cases, due to the conditions in their territories, these people have to work a lot harder. They have to help at home and work in the fields and this is even a bit tougher for women. In many cases, women are doubling their tasks. I mean, they have to work at home, they have to work in the field, they have to study, they have to receive training. So these are hardworking people. They must adapt to change. They have a lot of resources or develop those resources to move on. Solidarity was also mentioned. These are very solidary people. They support each other. There are many new characteristics or features, as you can see here. These are most of the characteristics of the descriptors used. And here they are in English. Okay, on post-COVID agriculture, let's talk about this. The idea is that this community can prevail over time so that it is not just an app or something necessary for today and tomorrow or for a single point in time. No, this is something for the long term. These are that is why we need this to be a living community at all times over time, because notice what is being said here. Notice what your rural youth says about their overview or their outlook of post-COVID agriculture. On one hand, they said it should be and must be more sustainable, containing more elements of coexistence with nature. They feel very responsible for natural resources. These are people that want to have the leadership within their rural community. Let me tell you that they also told us that although they want to apply knowledge and new technological projects out in the rural areas, they feel limited. They have many limitations. They don't have the tools, the knowledge, the expertise to do something like that. It will be difficult, a difficult agriculture with many challenges. Using a lot of electronic trade, e-commerce, excuse me, and these are basically the characteristics or description of post-COVID agriculture. And these are things we need to foster for more participation. The challenges, as I mentioned at the beginning, well, resources, money, jobs, how can we develop, produce the resources? Young people overall depend on their relatives, on their parents most often. And in this situation, they confront the need to generate even more resources to help at home. And another challenge is marketing. When you are confined, you well know, borders are closed, communities are closed. So it is very difficult to distribute our products. So how can we find people that have more experience in this? Perhaps there are other young people that have found a way out of this, a porthole, a loophole there. So we have to see where these they are and how to generate jobs and have better access to them. These are some of the many challenges. And we also have access to productive resources in order to produce, obviously. Ensure the safety of the community at all time. So we can see technological challenges once again here listed. And aside from this, there is the emotional side. People mentioned the lack of motivation, how to continue to be motivated in such a difficult context. With such a sanitary crisis we are in, like the one we are in, where training opportunities, job opportunities are so limited. How to keep hope open, alive? People, these are the words that that you mentioned, uncertainty, so much. This is quite a cluster of elements. So let us talk about opportunities. There are people, most of you are very optimistic, let me tell you. You said that although training and formal education and training are a challenge, you have found the ways. Most of you, most of the respondents said that you have found ways to get training and education, videos that show production techniques, innovation, and learning to sell your products differently. That was the biggest opportunity most of you saw. Always obviously concerned for having the best tools that will help you access content, expertise, exchanges, experiences that you can learn from. And technology should not be a limitation. In rural areas, we know it is much more difficult to connect and pay for access to data and to videos. That is much more difficult. So that is an opportunity, a technology in the virtual world. There are many people that have decided to place their products and those of their families through social media, through different tools, and this allows them to be connected with buyers and the family agriculture, the backyard gardens. People are so happy to see that the value of the rural areas is being now acknowledged, but it needs much more than that. We need to create policies to support these opportunities and productive processes. Okay, that was the English. You saw that quickly. Okay, now wrapping up. What are the characteristics of this community? Okay, for this community to be important and of value for you, what value should it contain? That was the question, I guess. So first of all, that it can be shared. Young youth sharing experiences, sharing knowledge, united, inclusive, because remember that, well, the economic, cultural, political, social level, at all those levels, there's also a need to value the rural areas to make this community attractive. You will give life to it. And we, ICA, and other partners, and other partner organizations will be facilitators of what you need so that the community can be dynamic with exchange and cooperation at all times, and obviously motivation. Okay, here you will see the different characteristics that will allow you to continue to take part in this community. I'm not going to elaborate more on that. You have the materials. Okay, let us talk about tools or modalities that this community should have. Well, one way or another, it should facilitate access to the internet, or find tools that facilitate access to materials. As I was saying, there must be a significant training, a growth of knowledge, the ability to identify opportunities, to generate resources, to find financing, and particularly to have interaction among youth. The young people must generate these materials and must support and motivate dialogue and interaction. This will help them leverage policies and produce policies and interact with other people with more power at the social level. Okay, lastly. There were several other questions, but one of the most relevant was, what social media do you visit the most? And what is missing in those social media for you to really feel it as a community? So we have the list here, and we discovered that the ones most used are YouTube and Instagram. With YouTube, people receive training. Obviously, there are funny videos too, but they get a lot of training there. That is a way to access other and more updated knowledge, almost free of charge. There's no need to pay for those courses. And then Instagram, as I mentioned, to connect to other people, because we can't see our friends and other people as before. Facebook Rica was mentioned, although it is not here on the list, that is also used, but at a more social level. To post things related to their products, their businesses, Twitter, Vimeo are used the least. There are not that many videos, and they're not as attractive at all. People mention they need a network that will allow them to make specific connections with the areas of interest, particularly to generate revenue and face the challenges brought about by COVID with greater trust and confidence. That in very general terms. Thank you very much for your attention. And now, I guess we can go to questions and comments. We have a few minutes available for that. In the chat box, there is a code. And you will be able to see, you can make your questions and comments right there.
Ya, en breve comparto la pantalla, un segundito.
I am just about to share the screen with you. And remember, please, that at 2:00 in the afternoon, Costa Rica time, we will have another presentation. We will see who is in charge. And from 4 to 5 p.m. Costa Rica time, we will have the mentoring or coaching sessions. And the team will be there to answer any questions you may have. The first question is, how do we think about encompassing most rural youth in the territories? Well, that is precisely the challenge. That is why we are here together. We are presenting these challenges and opportunities because this is a way to start or present in very general terms what most of the rural youth thinks and feels. We must consider diversity and differences, but the presentation that you already have in the kit presents what the majority of the rural youth that has responded to this question. Okay, there seem to be no further questions. So, let us wait a minute longer. We are about to start the second presentation. Very interesting, by the way. Personal growth. I will have to leave in a few moments because I have another activity scheduled on food security. So, okay, we have a question through the chat. The Zoom chat. Should the output be tangible or can it be an app? Oh, that is up to you, I guess. You have to discuss that with the community. You could select any tool, any technological tool or of any other nature that you believe can help you to create and maintain this community over time. Our colleagues from the coordinating team perhaps could add something to this. Iram has joined the session. Well, hello, everyone. Good morning. It's a pleasure to greet you once again. Let me select the Spanish for the translation. Okay. I would in line with what Nadia was saying, yes, the second part of the challenge, the idea is to whatever you develop in this challenge can be developed through a technological platform or app to make it available. So right now, what we will do is develop this idea of what that product could be like. And then in challenge two, which will start on October the 5th, the idea that comes out the winner will be developed, be it an app or a platform or whatever you define here. I guess that is what I could add for the time being. Thank you. Okay. Iram, good morning. I have told the participants about you. Very warm welcome. All the ICA coordinating team is glad to see you. I am sure that all participants are very excited to hear you talk about personal challenges, what will be of value for each one of them to build this youth community of the rural youth community of the Americas. Hello, hello, good morning. Thank you so very much. Thank you for the opportunity. I thank all the ICA team, Nadia. Oh boy, you are getting me in a pinch to talk about what is going to happen. If you allow me, I will share my screen and you let me know if you can see it. Okay. First of all, I would like to thank you for the opportunity. I am Iram Ibarra, and this concept of agribusiness coach that I took on, basically adopted many years ago or some years ago, I have found it very interesting. This is a very interesting idea. The agribusiness for yours truly are a big opportunity. And not only now that we are in this tunnel of opportunities, I don't like to call it the name everybody calls it because we have heard that term as several times, a lot of times, but how can we change this? How can we make sure that this moment turns into something different? Let me tell you very quickly. Before I start, let me tell you a story that is very connected to what we are doing. In front of you, you have something that, well, we have all identified. It is an elephant, right? This is a leg of an elephant. And we all know the elephants. We have seen those in the zoos and in the movies. You all remember Dumbo, right? But what is interesting, notice what is on this elephant's foot here. Can you see it? Well, just imagine, how many of you have wondered when you see this elephant at a distance and you wonder, gosh, that elephant doesn't know it weighs tons and it could break away that chain in no time. We really don't realize that that can happen. So that is what is so interesting. Why do I like the story of the elephant? Well, I used to be the same. I started in agribusiness about 18, 19 years ago. I am originally a public accountant. And I went to work at a mango exporting company. We were exporting mangoes to the United States and then Europe and Canada. And I was always wondering how the project and the packaging and the export could be done better, more efficiently, how we could have better income. Well, what happened? I realized that agro is a big opportunity, and that job led me to develop a joint venture with an Australian group. And we developed Alstar, an Australian technology that came to Mexico 15 years ago, more or less. I used to be providing advice as an accountant, now as Alstar. But let us look at the numbers. So what I could see was that mango producers, just as avocado producers or citrus producers, as well as many other producers, had a big issue there. Just looking at numbers. And one of my customers back then had problems to generate greater profit. So he asked me, what on earth do I do to increase production? And my answer was very simple, perhaps a bit blunt. Well, increase production. And he said, how do I do that? And I said, well, I don't know. Right then I remembered, I had heard an expert talking about how to increase production. So I did a postgraduate in agricultural business with a very clear objective to help producers so that if they could win, I could win too. And it was not easy, let me tell you. It was quite a tough start. But the final result was very interesting. We increased production 40%, and that was 17 years ago. Now, I would like to focus once again on the elephant. You may wonder about this elephant. Working with the Australians was a huge challenge for me. I had to do something. I had to repose many things. My cultural element as a Mexican, and I say this very respectfully, now in Latin America, our culture is very different. Our way of living is so different. And I can't continue to tell them, you do not know, this is Mexico. This is not like Australia. And when I go to Colombia, I hear the same. And when I've gone to Brazil or Peru or Chile, everyone says we are different. And that is absolutely right. So I was told, you need to be like the elephant, but change your mindset. And I said, what do you mean? This elephant you see here on the screen, not always has been in a chain. First of all, at the beginning, he was just tied with a rope, and it fought and fought and fought to get rid of the rope and wasn't able to. Maybe he cried and got frustrated and see he couldn't, so he stopped trying it. Excuse me. The elephant started with the chain on it, and as time passed and it grew up, then it started to give up, and they finally it became an adult, and they changed a rope, and it didn't even try. Now, once again, as a very large elephant, now it is once in a change. Why did not that elephant change that mindset? I remember I felt exactly the same thing. My original programming was that I would not be able to work with Australia, for example, that I would not be able to do whatever I dreamt I thought I could do, because my programming was so strong. And the owner of the company said, okay, either you change your programming or I will have to fire you. Ooh, that scared me. So I said, how do I do it? And he said, well, the first thing is ask yourself, what is tying you down to not change? So here's where the questions start for you. This is a personal innovation chat, a presentation, internal personal innovation. Innovation as such, if you go to Wikipedia, it says doing something different, a change. What better opportunity than this? through this tunnel of opportunities. Let us not focus on COVID. Let us reprogram us. Stop complaining. Stop saying, I'm not going to be able to do it. No. Identify what is tying you down, chaining you down to not change. Or, as I was told yesterday, they said, Edom, you have no idea. Our conditions here are not like in Mexico. Well, 17 years ago, I said exactly that. What I had to do was to identify what was anchoring down, what was my ballast and my chains, and recognize that and say, yes, that is true. I need to change. And this has to do with a neuro-linguistic programming that may make sense to many of you. Why do I mention this? Because everything we are talking about today is in your brain, and all of that you express and we know has a result and has an effect. Do the following. Don't believe a single word I'm going to say right now. Okay, we're in the agro. Trial and error, right? Am I right or wrong? Okay, take a plant or two plants. For one, talk to it every day in negative terms. Oh, you're useless. What a waste of time. But to the other one, compliment it, thank it. Let me tell you, take a picture of it and send it to me. Do it every day. The same plant, you will see the differences. And I applied that to myself. I started to talk to myself differently. I realized that if I talked to myself differently, my mind would understand things differently. Not only my words, but my thoughts. Oh, Edom, this isn't what exactly, this isn't what we expected. We have to change it. Well, that is the way to start. Check how artists and big entrepreneurs and different sports people see this, that this is the right time to be right now in this tunnel. We have no idea if we are at the beginning or in the middle or at the end of the tunnel, but we cannot get to the end of the tunnel, whenever that is, but be in the same situation, please. People always ask, when are we coming back to normal? And I say, well, isn't normal what brought us to where we are? Shouldn't we create something different? That is an idea. So there was a book called Six Pack for Life. I read this as a coach about 6 years ago. And I am an entrepreneur, let me tell you. I became trained the trainers and trained the entrepreneurs, and I am a mentor and a coach. I discovered something. It doesn't matter your companies, your titles, the projects, the money. If as a person we do not innovate, we do not change, we do not do something differently, this isn't going anywhere. Believe me. And I heard this in the previous presentation, what we need is commitment, a commitment to improve. The formula to success is knowledge plus attitude. And if we want to add something, experience. And this six pack we will see throughout the presentation, this is a tool that will be very useful to you. And I'm sharing it with you, not because it's my creation or no, it is very simple. Does it work? Yes, it works. It works if we work on it every day with very small changes. So this is the time to reorganize our cable, to reprogram. We need to do different things. Einstein used to say, if you want different outcomes, do things, different things. So why do we continue to do the same things expecting a different result? No, why don't we redesign something better? So a next question, I hope you're writing these down. Have you stopped to design your life? This would be a very good opportunity. Now that we are locked up, quote and unquote, captive or disconnected. Yes. Let me tell you something. In these months that we've been in confinement, have we not taken advantage to do different things differently? I hope so. This is the time to do it. Oh, Edom, you don't understand my conditions. The rural area, the old guys, no, they don't understand. They don't listen and blah, blah, blah. I'm never going to get out of this. My family either. My father, my grandfather were merchants. Is this going to change today? No, think differently. As often as you can, you need to do this personal reprogramming, internal personal innovation. Let me share a key element to all of this. I would ask you, how many of you today, the first thing you did when you opened up your eyes this morning was to thank? And if you did thank, for whatever, what was it about? Well, there cannot be innovation and change if I do not recognize or acknowledge what I have, the tools I have in order to change. Thanking is fundamental. Let me come back. Let me ask you the following. Let's see. What if what we are experiencing right now, this confinement, this tunnel, this storm, whatever we want to call it, is what we need to change? Have you wondered that? How many of us have not been asking for that change? Oh, I wish I could turn my dream into reality. I would love to have some time to write, to develop a business plan, to redesign my life. This is the time to do it. Do I have the right attitude or not? The right attitude has to do with thanking. One more. How many anchors from when I told you the story of the elephant to right now have you identified? Mother, father, uncle, partner. Are they anchors? No. No, we just need to identify them. We not only have to look outwards, we have to look inwards too. Oh, it is so easy to look outwards and add a descriptor to anyone, anything else out there. And I can say, oh, it is not my fault. It's the government's fault, or it's the weather's fault, or the seed's fault, or the institute's fault, or IECA's fault. It didn't give me the right tools, or it's Iram's fault. Let me share something with you. As entrepreneur, and now as a coach, I have discovered something. There is no one to blame. Blaming is equal to responsibility. When you blame someone, ask yourself, are they responsible? Or what are they responsible for? No. Part of what we want to change, once again, if we do not have the ability to recognize that what we have is not correct, there will be no change. You may be wondering, we were expecting something more from Edom. We wanted more techniques and tips. Let me tell you something. If we do not express things through our mouth, we will never get anywhere. Why do I dwell on this? Today, not only in Latin America, because we also have projects in the United States and Canada, what is not correct and is not working is communication. We let ourselves be taken by what we see, not by what we feel or by what we know. We doubt ourselves. And today is the time to not doubt. Look at this video with me. Watch this. In an experience at the School of Medicine of the University in Georgia, United States, a rat was exposed to a scent, and every day it was, every time the scent came, it was scared until the rat basically was afraid of the scent itself. This is a classical experience of psychological conditioning. The impressive part is the rat's offspring also were afraid of that stimulus, but not only its offspring, but the grand offspring also. So if you put a female rat separately, the same thing exactly passed on. This does not go through the genes, but you can inherit that to your children. Think of what your parents did and they taught you. Think of all these characteristics and functions that can be inherited from one rat to another, from a cell to another cell. There is really no change in the DNA, but these are all part of the epi, part of the genetics, and they are above genetics. Epic means on top of, above genetics, epigenetics. So it is written on top of the code you already have. Now we have ways of measuring the different brands. We have some models of how this works. These are chemical markers on the genes, and parts of the gene can be read or not, and part of the code can be read and parts of it cannot. Everybody may think you are an intellectual. Don't even believe it. It's the same with genes. If the gene is part of your genetic code and it cannot be read, it's as if you did not have it. And those markers are printed in the way in your being. Okay, let's stop it there. In this part we just heard at the end. What do I see that I do not see? That is the part I liked. Let me focus on five key things I have learned from genetics and neurosciences and from agronomy. The truth is that the video basically says that the environment imprints something on me. So with what I discovered when I just started my reprogramming, is that my father was that way, so I am that way. Does it make sense? Oh, well, my grandfather did, and my father did, and me too. So that is basically as if I were doomed to have to do it. What do I see that I do not see? No, we do not have to say, if I am the way I am, it's because of my father. I do not advance because then my father, my mother, my uncle, my grandfather, my partner, my teacher, whoever, will not give me the tools. No, no. What do I see that I do not see? The environment has to impregnate something into me. What is it doing right now? Complaints, uncertainty, fear, more uncertainty, more intimidation. So, see all those negative feelings? Let me propose the following. Write down all those negative emotions. Write those down. And simulate them as if they were building blocks. Okay, and see how you can turn fear into an ally. It should not determine your condition in order to move forward. Or as Charles Darwin says in his description of resilience, I don't care if you are the smartest. The truth is, no, if you are the strongest, I couldn't care less either. What I am interested in to see is how you adapt to change. What do I see that I do not see? Am I adapting to change, or will I continue the same? Or one of you, I could bet that some can say, gosh, this guy is crazy. as a public accountant, I never thought I would ever learn about agronomy, much less found a company and become a coach. Why have I done it? Because I feel passion for it. When I discovered I can do something that is not determined by what my parents or grandparents did, everything is possible. Everything is possible. And there's something very interesting here. We need useful thinking. Notice the screen, left side. Negative thoughts can lead us to see this tree that is drying out. A positive thinking will help me see a full tree, beautiful green. But we need useful thinking. We need to see the reality. We do not have a full tree. We do not have a tree that is drying out, but we have a process of change. Put that on your personal side. I am not like the green tree. I am not like the red one. I am in this process of change in the middle. If we accept and change, fine. But if I do not detect, I will never be able to create. We must create useful thinking. I ask you, if you had to do something out of the normal and test someone something or prove something that no one has ever tested, how can I go out? How can I grow? How can I work on art, or how can I work on whatever attitude? I was able to participate in the Latin American summit of a group of MIT experts in January, and there was a common denominator. What was it? Change. I could see my innovation in of my tool, and I could see my tools, but if I do not adapt to change, how can I harvest with robots? How can I measure, determine whether a bug has come into the area? So the question, my question to you is, would you do it? Or would you just stay put, waiting for someone else to do it? Reprogramming, how do I do it? Friends, we are in a process of change, a tunnel. Okay, this is an exercise, really, really. How many times have you gotten up with all these video conferences and Zoom sessions when we've taken a break to do 30 minutes of exercise? How many? Why? No? Well, somebody gave me, there was a Chinese fellow I met in Peru, and he said, if you want something to change, go against your own will. Go against your own will, he said. That has been with me ever since. Every day, I try to meditate, eat well, do exercise, because what you can see right now on the screen, this is your machine. Have you wondered why we play more with a computer than the piano? Or why do we pay more attention to our pet than to ourselves? Why can't we change? Why can't we move? Why don't we want to do something? As Martin Luther King said, if you cannot fly, run. If you cannot run, walk. If you cannot walk, crawl. Whatever you do, continue moving towards the future. Always move forward. In this world, we are wasting a lot of time thinking, imagining, but not executing. And the key to change is execution. Change, organize yourself, carry an agenda. How many of you carry an agenda? Very interesting. What is not on the agenda, you do not do. Oh, why? We could continue forward with many projects, but this is basically a big failure in all we all have. I want to do everything, but I don't have the time to do it. So I was asked, how do you see ABC project? Well, oh, how are you doing on ABC project? Oh, yeah, well, I'm working on it. I don't know. How many hours a day do you focus on it? How many effective hours? I will pose an interesting question. How much time do you spend on your computer, either on Instagram or Facebook, on WhatsApp, whatever? How much time do you invest? I think we have realized right now that I think we can notice we can stop physically going to work or physically using the car, physically using gasoline, yes, but we cannot go without eating or sleeping. This is our machine. Isn't it time to innovate, but personally, to organize ourselves much better, to devote quality time, not quantity time, to what we want to need to do? Look at that. Measure the time you spend on social media. You can say whatever you want to. No, you have to answer that question yourselves. We must focus on solutions. This is a key to the program you are going to start, you are about to begin, and the challenges you will be facing. The best tip or suggestion is focus on solutions, not on the problem. The problem is there. The solutions are the ones we need to work on through using the best tools in order to validate. If you focus on the problem, well, the problem is going to get bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger. Try it. Everything will change. Okay, what is the most valuable thing that human beings have? Time. It is priceless. But time well invested leads to money. And the time well invested, the time well developed but poorly invested would lead to a loss of money. What we need is profits. Without profits, if we do not reinvest those, that will in the end lead to losses. It is a continuous flow, a virtuous circle. Okay, my next question, do you have a budget? Have you developed a budget? How much, or how many of you know how much it will cost, how much you have to invest, how much you will get in return? Think about that. Somebody says, oh, I have a great project, Iram, for you to work in Colombia or Costa Rica. My question will be, what is the investment? What is the return? Invest $6,000. Okay, fine. What is the return? I'm working on that. No. If you do not know your return, you don't even have a project. Forget it. My grandfather, may he rest in peace, used to say, before produce, sell. If you come with me to give you money to invest, I am not going to invest. If you come with me because you are selling and you need money to have a higher level of income, I will be with you. Believe me, it works. Before you produce, sell. A budget of income and expenses and time. And this takes us back to the agenda. How much should I invest? And how do I visualize that? We have to see these ideas and projects and dreams, yes. But how many of you? And I'll give you some homework. I'll give you some homework right now. Do it today. I will leave some data. If you want to send me a message, go ahead and do it. But the objective of this exercise I will leave you with is to listen. Listen. When you get home, or if you are at home, or whenever you have a chance, sit down with the members of your family or household and ask. I was given a challenge, a homework. What are you dreaming of? And write that down. If something within you does not shift and move with such a simple question, the exercise will be a total failure. But let me tell you, what will move you is what will help you take one more step forward in personal growth. Why do I know that? Because I have done it. But don't believe it. Validate it on your own. We have to set aside all this matter of, once again, oh, it does not work because we're not Germany, we're not the Netherlands. No, listen, friends, we're all at the same level right now. We have a very extensive network in Latin America and the United States and France and the Netherlands. The common denominator is that we are all reposing the strategy. We want to innovate. We want to innovate, do something differently, but we cannot be productive if we do not decide to change a different route. A disruption is basically taking a different angle. Yeah, and we can do it. Yes, experiment, validate, experiment, knock on doors. Nothing will happen. You may be rejected. Hopefully you can sell something. Someone could say, well, Oid, I'm your cruel talking about being rejected. No, no. We remember we always learn from failure. The success is the prize. Otherwise, we will be a total failure. Henry Ford, I believe, said this. Success is the result of all failures added up. How many times have I failed? Many times. I opened up a company in Brazil that went bankrupt. 2 years later, I lost a lot of money. Then I did projects in Venezuela, in Colombia, in Mexico, in the US. Well, why are you still here? Because this is life, trial and error, like agriculture. And if you like I believe we're in the same line. We see the big opportunity that exists out there. Well, why not? Usain Bolt, I'm sure you have heard about him. He said it's incredible. I don't know why entrepreneurs, students give up to a process, a diet or doing exercise or studying or do not move a project forward. He said, I trained for 7 years to run a 4-minute race. How ironic, right? So I would say, like I tell myself when I want to give up, are you willing to give up this all of this up? Perhaps the goal is right at the end, right around the corners. So we just need to accept that trial and error is necessary because that will help you improve each one. This video I will leave with you. Watch it. Here it says I am Mexican, but this applies basically to anyone in Latin America. Dedicated to haters, that since you were not born here, you cannot do anything. You will not be successful. You were lucky to grow a country that continues to change every day and shows the need to reinvent. Almost 2 million square kilometers. So many people come and say, no, you can't, you can't. Excuse me, the audio is very difficult. Saturated audio. I am doing my best. You all of a sudden you say, no, I can't, I give up. No, I can't, no, I can't. You do not need money. You do not need context. You do not need an easy road. The opportunities are not found. You need peace of mind to go out in the street, but you need the desire, the pride, and the resilience to move forward. If you do too much, you realize it is going to be difficult. Learn to avoid all the hurdles and obstacles in the way. Feel inspired. No matter how distant your goal may seem, go for it anyway. Every time you fall, stand up again, keep going. No one should stop you. Be determined, even if you want to give up, continue to prepare yourself. So when they tell you that you will never be able to walk in space, dream about it, work on it. Do whatever you can. Every time they tell you you cannot do something, work on it to show them that yes, you can. Do it. And when they ask you, how did you do it? Respond, I am. And this is where I would say, I am a citizen of the world. I will change that. We can all do what we want. But above all, face challenges. As my grandfather said, is that life is of the bold. But what can prevent you from doing anything is fear. Do not let fear get in your way. There are many things we cannot do overnight, so do not be impatient. Many of us want to plant today and harvest tomorrow. No, that does not work that way. We have to plant even in the shortest cycle. We have to wait. Thank you all very much. I am Irán Ibarra, and I thank you very much for allowing me to contribute something. I hope you have found it interesting. I hope I have contributed. If you didn't like it, well, there's nothing I can do about it. No, just joking. I am at your order if you have any questions, at your service. Thank you, Irán. Is it a pleasure? Thank you so very much. The presentation was very pro-positive, very proactive. It has filled us with energy, with all the elements, the commitment, innovation, not wanting everything for right now, but instead work gradually, both internally and as well as at all levels of our lives. In the Zoom chat box, we have the Mentis code, the Mentis code for you to post questions. We have a question now. Can we consider ICA's support to consolidate the community that we may propose? Which would be its functions to help the community move forward? Oh, well, this basically is addressed at us. Let me answer, but Irán, if you have any other ideas to add, well, feel free. But in these few days, I believe tomorrow afternoon, there will be a presentation where we will talk about diversity, governance. And when we talk about governance, basically we refer to how this hemispheric community of rural youths should work or operate, as Nadia was mentioning at the beginning. Well, we are a team, all ages, with great enthusiasm. And we wondered what if we create a platform? Well, if we do it from the institutional side, youth would not feel ownership over the process, and it would be very complicated to involve them. That is what we will be talking about tomorrow. So what can I answer right now to this question? Yes, you can count on all our willingness, energy, and desire to help you. But some of the elements of how this will move forward does not really depend on us. Oh, we could give you all the platforms, all the facilities, but if in the end there are no young people committed to bring this to life, it will be very complicated. And remember that we not only have IICA here, but we have our paratechnical friends with us. And we are working also with the experience and knowledge we all have together to create this community. Iram, I wonder whether you have any comments about this part. Yes, of course. And thank you for giving me the opportunity. I would just like to talk about something I read in a book. Ask. As founder of the Latin American Association of Young Entrepreneurs, I have personally seen that sometimes we participate in a project and months go by and some people said, oh, I forgot about it, or I didn't dare take the first step. No, we all learn on the way. One of the main functions of both parties is to listen and ask. There are no stupid questions. Remember that always. That is my biggest recommendation. Okay. We have two more questions through the Zoom chat. Jacqueline is asking, do you believe that only technology can connect more rural youth? No, by no means. Technology should be the second step, in fact. There is a parenthesis here. We are all focused on artificial intelligence and all those things. Yes. Do we clearly understand what it will help us for? Secondly, wouldn't it be better that to ask and read from entrepreneur and contact entrepreneur to entrepreneur and learn better? Something that is affecting us, in my view. I'm not against technology, no, by no means. We work a lot on artificial intelligence, but oftentimes we forget that this also serves to talk, not just to send messages. Sometimes in a message, I cannot say what I would like to say via my voice. The best way to communicate is by talking, speaking through our voice. And with technology today, with this global network, I can pick up the phone and talk to someone in India, in Australia, in Costa Rica to talk. And we forget about that part. No, this is not the only platform. So first of all is back to the basics. Share and ask, how can I contribute to certain projects? Oh, thank you so much. Okay, and Gilberto Garcia is asking, is the current pandemic an opportunity for entrepreneurs and why? Well, no doubt whatsoever. The current pandemic is the best of opportunities. That is why I called it a tunnel of opportunities. I mentioned this during the presentation. You could cease doing a lot of things, but you cannot stop eating. Oh, yes, it would be good to go to the basic traditional models. No. There is a group in Costa Rica called Pupila. And they have a site, Agriculture, the cool of how cool that is, Agriculture. So they said started with the traditional model with these little small vendors on the street, but we decided to put them all together in a bigger market, that is through innovation. The big challenge is to dare do things. People say, oh no, I'm ashamed. Come on, I used to have a company and now the pandemic came and now I am nobody. I'm a total failure. What is everybody going to say about me? No. as I said before, life is for the bold. Go ahead, move forward. That is the best. Okay, perfect. I think, Manuel, we have no further questions through Mency either. Negative. Okay, Aidan. We have to do is thank you for your time and for sharing all those tools with us. And thank you for the motivation to move forward. And previous presentations have highlighted the importance of the problems and the issues that have been identified for rural youth of the America and how we can build a community. And now here you come today to give us all these tools to motivate us, to encourage us to innovate, to focus on solutions, not just on the problems. That phrase for me was very, very important in my view in order to move on. And I would like to thank you. Before ending, I have some general comments for all our participants. Yesterday, we said that we are recording the presentations and we are uploading them an hour later. It is taking us a little longer, I'm sorry. You will find the presentations up on Discord, but 2 hours later, please, we apologize. And remember that today, 2 p.m. Costa Rica time, we have the second presentation. So we hope to see you here then. Thank you all very much for your commitment. Have a very pleasant morning or afternoon, and we will see you in a while. Thank you, Iram. Have a very good day. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you all. Goodbye.